Hello children, and welcome to Sarita Ma'am's class. In last video, we have learnt about the chapter. I explained you the whole chapter, the speciality of Tarnetar Fair. And we ended with this picture of umbrella, which is decorated very nicely. It looks attractive. Small handkerchiefs are tied at the end of the umbrella. It looks very elegant. So with this, we completed our chapter. Now let's move towards exercise. So let's start. Our first exercise is, that is given in activity 4. It is match A with B. As you can see on the screen that in column A, the words that came in our chapter, that means that are used in the chapter, are given. And its meaning are given in column B. So let's match them and let's see the answer of or the meaning of each word. Let's start. The first one is mundane. Let's see what is the meaning of mundane. Mundane means dull or ordinary. Whirlwind. What is the meaning of whirlwind? Whirlwind means happening very fast. Now the third word is ethnic. Let's see the meaning. What is the meaning of ethnic? Ethnic means connected with a nation, race, people that shares a tradition. That means aisi cheez or aisi vastu jo nation ya kisi race se ya kisi पर्टिकुलर पीपल से कनेक्ट हो. ओके, नाउ व्हाट इज यूनिसन. सी चिल्ड्रन, यूनी यूनी मीन्स इक्वल. ओके, सेम, जैसे कि यूनिक है ना, यूनिक इज आल्सो समथिंग डिफरेंट. सो व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ यूनिसन? यूनिसन मीन्स ऑल डू समथिंग एट द सेम टाइम. नाउ लेट्स सी द लास्ट मीनिंग, सर्ज. Now let's see what is the meaning of surge. Surge means quickly with force in a particular direction. So I hope you have understood meaning of this 5 words. Now let's see the next 5 words. Okay, the 6th one is spouse. Let's see what is the meaning of spouse. Yes, spouse means a husband or a wife. In Tarnetar Fair, man and woman came there to seek a or to find a spouse. Okay. Now next one is spontaneous. Let's see the meaning. Spontaneous means not planned. And captivating, it's enchanting. What is the meaning of enchanting? Enchanting means attractive. Okay. So now next is exquisitely. Now let's see what is the meaning of exquisitely. Extremely beautiful or carefully made. And the next is unique. Unique means one of its kind, something special. Now let's see the last 6 words. Next is embellishment. Let's see the meaning. Decoration or embroidery. The next word is initiate. Initiate means begin or set in motion to start. Now clack. This sound is very beautiful. Clack. Let's see its meaning. The sound when hard object hit each other. Okay. It's a sound when any hard object hit each other. That is called clack. Now next is incessant. Let's see its meaning. Constant. Yes, nice. And now next is potential. Let's see the meaning. Potential means capability. Okay, to do something. That means ability to do. That is called capability. Now entice. The last word is entice. Entice means to persuade Persuade means to explain something. Okay. So this were meanings that were given in our activity 4. Now let's move towards our next activity, that is activity 5. Let's read what is given in that activity. A. Tick mark the option that is most appropriate. References are given. That means, children, in each and every question, there is reference of paragraph number is given. So, you have to find out the answers from the paragraph that is mentioned in each question. Okay. So, let's read the first question and try to find out the answer of it. The first one is, Rashmi, a Rabari girl, participates in the Rahdo. She is dressed in a dazzling red zini. Now, which statement is true? Now, you have to tell 3A, B and C. Three statements are given below. And reference of paragraph number 2 you have to take. So, try to find out what will be the answer of this question. Let me read the option. A potential husband may seek her as a bride. B1 is, she is a married girl taking part in the festivities. And C is, it is a tradition and therefore she must join in the dance. Now tell me, what is the answer? A. A potential husband may seek her a bride. Now let's move towards the second one. A group of tourists from Bhavnagar wishes to attend the Tarnetar fair. The cheapest and shortest route. You should advise them to take is. Now we have to complete the sentence. Again, three options are given below and we have to refer paragraph number 7. So first of all, let's read the option. The first one is, to go to Chotila via Rajkot and then take the ST bus to Thangad. Second one is, to go to Chotila from Ahmedabad and then take the ST bus to Thangad. The third one is, to go via Botad to Chotila and then take the ST bus to Thangad. Now children, tell me what will be the answer of this second one? Yes, correct. It is B, to go to Chotila from Ahmedabad and then take the ST bus to Thangad. Okay. Now let's see the next. Third one is, if you are planning to attend the Tarnetar fair, you will do the bookings for the month of. So for this answer, you have to refer paragraph number 6. You must know when this fair is held. So, you have to tell the month. Options are given. Let's read. The first one is June, July. Then August, September. Or October, November. Come on children. This is very easy. You can answer it. Yes, very good. It's August, September. Okay. Now, the last one. A young collie plans to impress the girls at the fair. Therefore, he spends over a year preparing himself by. Now, we have to complete this sentence by finding out the correct option from the given below. And for this, you have to refer paragraph number 8. So, let's read the option first. The first one is, making small colorful handkerchiefs. Second is, embroidering exquisite designs on his umbrella. And the third one is, practicing his art and getting ready his clothes and headgear. Now tell me, what is the answer for this? Yes, it's B. Embroidering exquisite designs on his umbrella. So children, these were the answers of activity 4 and activity 5. I hope you have noted down these answers in your book. So, in our next session, we will learn about activity 5, the remaining part, that is B section, in which question answers are given. And then we will discuss activity 6, 7 and 8. Till then, you write down this in your notebook and take care. Bye-bye.